Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Outlook video, I'm going to show you how to use and create an Outlook meeting template that you can use whenever you want to. Let's go ahead and dive in right now. So before I do this real quick, if I want to do a one-time meeting with a customer or a client, I'm just going to do a new meeting request. If I want to have a recurring meeting, I'm going to click on New Recurring Meeting. And this is something, as an example, a staff meeting, daily, weekly, every other week, monthly, same day, same time. That's a recurring meeting. But frequently, we have meetings that aren't recurring and aren't one time. So in my example, I'm a software trainer. So let's say I'm doing Excel Essentials, Excel Intermediate, and Excel Advanced, and people are calling me all the time for training. One day the class is at 10 o'clock, one day the class is at 2:30, another day they may schedule a class for 1 in the afternoon. So it's the same meeting invite, but it's going to different people for different dates and times. So I'm just going to right click and do a new meeting request to get started. When this box appears, this is my Excel Essentials training. I'm making this up. Required, I'm always sending this to different people because different clients or customers are calling me. But I have a coworker that always wants to be notified about this, and that is Carol Wilson. So I did use the optional line. The date and time, this class is for an hour and a half, and I don't believe it's going to remember this, but I'm just going to go ahead and make it an hour and a half. Location, if this was a Teams meeting, I would type in Teams meeting, Zoom, WebEx, whatever it is. If it's on-site, you just maybe put in on-site and put your physical address there. And so you don't have to sit here and watch me type. There are the details in the body of the email. Those will always appear. So notice I even have a hyperlink in here to some files and other information for Excel Essentials. So this is the template for the Essentials, but if I did Intermediate, Excel, and Advanced, I would have templates for them too. So now let me show you how to save this and then we'll end up using it. So here you go, File, Save As. Major step right here, this is the default format type right here. Immediately change this to Outlook Template. Before I change this to Outlook Template, look up top where it says PC Documents. Now I'm going to change it, watch this. It needs to be set up in this path, and it jumps to this path automatically. So now it's an Outlook template. Excel Essentials Training, that sounds good. Click Save. Close this, and don't save it. Now I'm going to jump to another week. And a client wants training on Tuesday. I don't even care. I'm going to click on 10 o'clock. Go to the Home tab. So notice I'm not right-clicking doing a meeting request. I'm going to use New Items, More Items, Choose Form. When I come here, Standard Forms Library is the default. You want to change this to your User Templates in File System. And look. If I would have went through all three of these, I would have had Essentials, Excel Intermediate Training, and Excel Advanced Training. They want Essentials Training. Click on Open. It remembered the title. It's got Carol Wilson in here. See, it went back to that default date. That's why I said don't even really worry about the date and time. So let me tell you a tip, a major tip right here from Chris Menard. I always put in the required people last. These are usually people outside my company or organization. That way I don't actually send this until I'm done. But I do work from the top down except for the required field. So I forgot what day that was. Obviously you would know. Let's make it August 17th. Change the time. They requested 9 o'clock to 10:30. Location would have already been filled in, by the way. That would have stuck if I would have used it. Here's everything else below. So everything looks good. I come back. I'm going to send this to Christian just to test this. Act like Christian is outside my company. and he's a customer. Everything looks good. Hit send. Almost hit send anyway. But it's asking for the location. I should have filled it in on the template, but I'm going to hit send anyway. And there it is. So that is how you create a calendar template. I use this all the time. It beats trying to copy and paste. Because remember, your Windows clipboard can only hold 25 items in the clipboard. By the way, if you didn't know that, there's a video down below on how to use the Windows clipboard to hold 25 items. Feel free to subscribe. Let me know if you have any questions about this video. I appreciate your time. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.